Has anybody seen the Jobs movie? At least a few people have seen it. Kind of disturbing, but I enjoyed it. A lot of people hated it. I thought it wasn't entirely accurate, but there were some scenes in there where they really did capture the intensity of Steve. But there was nothing in the movie, take it back, there was one thing in the movie that I had anything to do with in real life, and that was the recording of that soundtrack. And in the movie, he reads that, he doesn't read it very well in the movie, to be honest, but he gives the quiet read, and then he just looks at the camera and he says, "Is that okay?" And I'm like, no, that's not the way it happened. But it's Hollywood, they're allowed to tell it. Actually, I think my story would have been funnier, but that was the end of the movie, and it kind of goes to the credits after that. It's like his one quiet moment in the movie. And then there is the matter of that little thing, something I do bear some responsibility for, which is somewhat embarrassing and humbling all at the same time. Keep in mind that I'm a writer, and I have written longer things than that. But for some reason, nobody remembers those things. So it was the name of iMac, and I'll tell you a little story about that in a moment. But then, of course, from iMac came all these other iThings. And not only from Apple, then iThings started appearing all around the world. I saw this one in Copenhagen, one of my favorites. But the task was this. Back in those days, and the more years pass, the more painful it is to tell the story, because some people may not remember when computers were all beige and boxy and ugly, but they certainly were. And iMac was the first computer to break the mold, and it was something that Steve was betting the company on. So he wanted us to come up with a really good name. He called us in one day and he said, "I have a name that I really like. We're going to go with it, but if you guys can do better, we need you to do better within the next 2 weeks." So his name was this. Yes, it's true, MacMan. And trust me, we had long conversations about it. It was a bit on the sexist side. He had two things he said the name should accomplish. One is it should not make it appear to be portable, so it had this big handle on the top, but it would weigh 50 pounds. That was just there for convenience. Second, but we're thinking, well, why would you call it MacMan? Because it sounds like Walkman, which is the world's most portable device. He also didn't want it to sound like a toy, because it looks sort of playful, but it's a serious computer. So again, we were thinking, well, MacMan sounds like Pac-Man, which was one of the most popular games out there at the time. So it had everything wrong about it. And I don't know, maybe this will give you all reason to justify your baseless opinions, but no amount of fact would sway him. It's just, I like it. It's like, you can't argue with that. And, you know, whether he was a genius or not, he was fixated on MacMan. There's still a bunch of my former colleagues and I, every time we see each other, it's kind of like, MacMan. It's like, it's just a fun story for us. But we're very, glad that it worked out the way it did. I actually presented like five names to him the first time. And I should stop, I should quit while I'm ahead, but we had names like Maxter and Mac Rocket, things that were not very good. And then we saved iMac for the end, because I was pretty sure it was the killer name. And Steve hated the first four names, and I showed him iMac, and it was like, I hate it also. So go back and think of some more. So we came back a whole week later. I showed him three new names. He didn't like any of those, and then said, but we still like iMac. And at that point, he said, I don't hate it this week, but I don't like it either. So now you've got 2 days. And unfortunately, there is no real ending to the story, because the next day I was talking to a friend at Apple who said, did you hear that Steve had the name put on one of the models and he's showing it around, he's getting good reactions. So I never said another thing. There was never an agreed moment of, there wasn't an email or phone call or anything like that. It was just suddenly iMac. And for that, we're all very thankful, because had we not persevered, you might well be sitting there with your PhoneMans and your PodMans. Wouldn't that be silly?